Loving others well is the theme for this week's Truths for Troubled Times devotionals. And I get to share how to love your family well during this unique season of life. And this devotional is aimed at dads and moms with kids of all ages who are living at home. But hopefully, what I'll be sharing can also be brought into roommates or extended family and friends who don't live with you, but who you can love by reaching out to them. You know, there's a lot to say on this topic, but I felt the best way to talk about it is to give you 6 encouragements so that you can love your family well. And what undergirds all these encouragements to love your family is by thinking of your family members as more important than yourself. And this comes by having a heart of humility like our Savior, Jesus Christ. You know, the Apostle Paul writes in Philippians chapter 2, "So if there is any encouragement in Christ, any comfort from love, any participation in the Spirit, any affection and sympathy, complete my joy by being of the same mind, having the same love, being in full accord and of one mind. Do nothing from selfish ambition or conceit, but in humility count others, your spouse and your kids, more significant than yourself." You know, humility will always lead to loving others well. So let's start with our first encouragement. Love your family well by thinking of a plan for your spouse and kids. You know, what I mean by this is block out a minimum of 15 minutes to ask yourself 3 questions. The first question is this: before COVID-19, what did you wish you could do with your family but couldn't because life was too busy? Second question: what are specific ways God wants to grow your love for your spouse and your kids during the stay-at-home season? And lastly, this can be expanded beyond your immediate family, but what would you regret if you didn't do it during this time? And after you've thought about these 3 questions, come up with a plan. So love your family well by reflecting and providing a plan for them. Second, love your family well by creating a new spiritual norm for your spouse and kids. For many of us, the pre-COVID-19 life was really a life of practicality and efficiency in order to survive. And that was the norm for many of us. Rush to wake up and make breakfast, drop off the kids, go to work or crank out the errands, make it in time to pick up the kids, choreograph the drive schedule to make it to piano practice, then basketball practice, squeeze in homework, and then finally prepare dinner and showers, repeat the next day. You know, now is the time where you can create a new spiritual norm for your family. You know, is it starting to meet together for family worship time? Is it reading a Christ-centered book together before the kids go to bed? Is it setting aside an evening to pray as a family? You know, is it doing the dishes and just talking about what Jesus is doing in your lives? You know, be creative and think of a new spiritual norm for your family. Third, love your family well by being present with your spouse and your kids. You know, the challenge I'm facing is the blurred line between home life and work life. You know, the first 3 weeks of stay at home, I was constantly checking my phone and going to the computer to make sure Lighthouse was being cared for, but neglecting being present with my family. You know, so be present with your family. Put your phone away during mealtimes, or set aside a time each day or evening not to check social media, but to use it to focus on your spouse or your kids. You know, another way to be present is to see God's grace. See being able to play catch with your son, watch your baby crawl, take an evening walk with your teen, to just having meals together as a grace of God. You know, don't take these moments for granted. These are gifts from God, so don't miss them because you're looking at your phone or another screen. You know, fourth, love your family well by praying for your and with your spouse and kids. You know, one of the things I've been trying to do is pray daily for my wife and girls. I'm praying big prayers like salvation for the kids and keeping healthy during this pandemic. You know, what I'm also learning how to do is pray for specific things that are smaller as well. You know, I'm also getting the family involved by having them pray for specific things as well. You know, I want them and I want us to see that our faith is at work as we pray as children to our Heavenly Father. You know, what are some specific things you can be praying for your spouse? You know, what are specific prayers you can lift up for your kids? Fifth, Love your family well by sacrificing your kingdom to grow Christ's kingdom in your spouse and your kids. You know, basically what I'm saying is sacrifice your time, your schedule, and your view of rest to love your spouse and your kids in a way where they'll be encouraged to love Christ so much more. You know, by your example of patience, when an important online meeting looks like a very bad dubbed foreign film because your kids are playing video games and sucking up all the bandwidth, just having a listening ear, to kindness by going the extra mile to help your child with their homework when you've got a lot to going on, perseverance when what you planned for a family worship time just ends in an argument. You know, sacrifice your kingdom to grow Christ's kingdom in your family. You know, and lastly, love your family well by asking your spouse and your kids for forgiveness. You know, may have painted a perfect family scene with the previous five ways, but the reality is that cabin fever set in, along with moments when a particular family member has pushed all the buttons to set you off. And love your family well has often been switched with loving your enemies well. You know, but the last grace of loving our family well is by putting into practice the forgiveness we've received from Christ, by asking for forgiveness when we've sinned, and forgiving others when they've sinned against you. You know, we're not going to be sinless, and there may have already been times of major blowups, but with Christ, there is hope because of the forgiveness we've received as God's children. You know, in these moments of asking for forgiveness, may be the lasting memory your family has of this COVID-19 season. And if it is, then the season will have been used well. For you and your family will have a greater appreciation and will have a deeper experience of Christ's forgiveness. You know, so what are you going to do to love your family well during this time? Don't waste it. Let's pray. Father, I do pray that you would take just the words from Philippians chapter 2 and embed it within our hearts so that we may learn what does it mean to love our spouse and our kids well. Help us to use this season, this very unique season, to be able to disciple and shepherd and to love our family so that at the end of it, they will love Christ so much more. We thank you and pray this all in Jesus' name. Amen.